today's daily challenge, in the first line of input, we are given the values of R and C. And then we are given a R cross C matrix as input. And then we are given 4 integers as input. So out of these 4 integers, the first 2 represents an integer in the matrix. So the first 2 is 2, 2. So the second row, second column element. So it represents this element 32. And then the remaining 2 elements 5, 4. So fifth row, fourth column. So this last element. And it is given in the question that these two integers are opposite corners of a submatrix. And our task is to find that submatrix. So here, in this submatrix, these two integers would be the opposite corners. So only in this submatrix, the integers 32 and 86 would be their opposite corners. So we are printing this submatrix as our output. Now let us see our sample input 2. So here the value of R is 3 and the value of C is equal to 6. And we are given a R cross C matrix as input and then the 4 integers. So the first 2 integers is 3, 3. So the third row, third column. So this element 21 and then 1, 5. So first row, fifth column. So this 60. And as per the question, these two integers are opposite corners of a submatrix and our task is to find that submatrix. So here in this submatrix, these two integers 21 and 60 would be the opposite corners. So we would be printing this submatrix as our output. So we are printing 85, 43, 60. Now let us see how we would be printing this submatrix as our output. So the starting element of the submatrix is 85 and the ending is 31. So let us calculate the positions. So the starting point is from the index 1, 3, because the integer 85 is present at first row, third column, and the ending is 31 and it is present at third row, fifth column. So the ending is 3, 5. So from this we can see that the minimum row is 1 and the maximum row is 3 and the minimum column is 3 and the maximum column is 5. So to obtain this, we would be using this 4 integers. So here out of these 4 integers, the first 2 is the row and column for the first and the second 2 integers are the row and column for the second corner. So we would be using the positions of rows and columns separately. So this 3 and this 1 represents the row and this 3 and this 5 represents the column. So we would be starting from minimum and going till the maximum. So to print the submatrix, we would start from minimum row, minimum column and go till maximum row, maximum column. So here the integers which represents the row are 3 and 1 and the minimum value is 1. So we would be starting to iterate from the first row and go till the third row. And similarly for the column, the integers 3 and 5 represent the column. So the minimum value is 3 and the maximum value is 5. So we would be starting to iterate from the third column and go till the fifth column. So the first integer of our submatrix would be the first row, third column, and the last would be third row, fifth column. So we will be able to print our submatrix. Now let us see how to write a C program for this. So let us start from our main function. So first I am creating some integer variables and in the next line I am accepting the values of R and C. And then I am creating a two-dimensional array named mat of size R cross C. So we will be storing our input matrix into this two-dimensional array. And using a nested for loop, I am accepting the input matrix. And now after accepting the input matrix, I am accepting the 4 integers which were given in the input. So now I am creating a for loop that iterates from minimum of x1, x2, -1. So here this min is a user defined function. So this function accepts two integers in its arguments, and if a is greater than b, the function would return b, because this function would return the minimum of a and b. So if a is greater than b, then b is the minimum, so b will be returned, or else a would be returned. And similarly, another function named max, so this would accept again two integers in its arguments, and if a is greater than b, it would return a, or else it would return b. So it would return the maximum integer of a and b. So in our for loop, we would be using these functions min and max. So as we discussed, we would be iterating from minimum of x1 comma x2. So the x1 and x2 represents the row. So this x1 and x2 are for rows, and y1 and y2 are for columns. So minimum of x1 comma x2 and till maximum of x1 comma x2. And here I am including this minus 1 because we are accepting our integers from 0. So minimum of x1 comma x2 minus 1 would be the starting position of our row. And the same for column elements. So the j loop also starts from minimum of y1 comma y2 minus 1 and iterates till maximum of y1 comma y2. So in every iteration, we would print the matrix element at the current iteration of I and Y. So now let us check our program with sample test cases. So now I have given the sample input 1, and the highlighted part is our expected output. So we are also getting the same. And now I have given the sample input 2, and here the red part is our output. So we are also getting the same. So this is the logic behind today's daily challenge. Thank you for watching.